G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. Just thought I'd show you a little wheel set I picked up the other day and I'm pretty happy with. This one's from a DEF model, 135 scale. And while it's for quite a few Jeeps, as you can see, they've got it down there for the Temir, Dragon and Bronco kit. And I'm guessing with probably a little bit of modification, it can probably fit on the, what's the other two kits that are coming out, the Mang one and the Tacon one as well. But I just bought these wheels because I was thinking about putting them in a bit of a winter scene on my Temir Jeep, which it looks like that's probably what they've got in the photo there. I've picked up a couple of these wheel sets before with the chains on them, some of the older ones, not from DEF model, but from other companies. And I found that the chains had been sort of, the casting wasn't done very well. So the chain around the tyre had been sort of broken into pieces because the casting wasn't that good, or when it came out of the mold it had broken off or something like that. So I've picked up a couple of DEF models pieces and kits before, and I've been really happy with their molding. I thought I'd give this set a shot. And the other thing that's nice about these DEF model kits, you also get a wheel mask for the tires, which may not show up exceptionally well though, guys, because it's you can just see it there. The instructions on the back there if you've never done one before. And on the other side there, just some advertising of some of the other sets they do. And if you've seen my Shimmer Wagon overload video, you'll know that I've picked up a set of the fat tires for the Shumi. I think I've also picked up just the standard tires as well, because I'm doing a Temir SAS Jeep as well. So I picked up some of the standards. Actually, there's two different types of tyres you can pick up if you wanted to do like the SAS Jeep, to have, you know, a couple of tyres different from the other ones. So I think I've picked those up as well. So as you can see, guys, you get the spare as well without the chains on it. And hopefully it'll show up here that the casting on these tyres or wheels, absolutely fantastic. And if you go and have a look at the chains, which I'll try and bring a little bit closer to the camera if I can, the chains around the tyres are done exceptionally well. Apologise, guys, if my hand's a bit shaky. But just that you can see that the chain is, well, to my eye anyway, might not show up that well on the screen, but the chains around the tyres are done exceptionally well. Not really many breakages in the chain. And I'm not sure, because it says the Temir Dragon and Bronco kit, I'm not sure if they all have the same connection points to the wheels, because apart from the wheels, you don't get any other little add-on little interior hub things for different types of connections to the kit. So I'm not sure if they all have the exact same connection or not. So just be wary of that. It does say it on the box art, but I actually don't have all those three kits, so I can't tell you exactly if that's correct or not. Now, the one thing I'd mention about this set, if you're thinking about buying it, is that there is a A and B there. And as you can sort of see, and I apologize, guys, I'm not sure of the exact terminology, but you can see in the center of the hubs, they're all pretty much the same or extremely close to it, to my eye. They could be just minor differences in diameter from A to B. And I think I noticed this with my SAS Jeep when I was starting to put that together, that if you look at the centers of this, and if you take on the Temir Jeep here, you can see that the front is different to the back. This center hub thing here compared to there. So someone can always chime in, little Jeep guru. I'll have to do some research on that before I start whacking these ones on the back, because they do give you five wheels in the set. So, you know, obviously you just assume that you could put these on the back as well. But I'm not entirely sure if that is correct. So if someone can leave me a comment and let me know, that'd be great. But other than that, but as far as the casting goes and the pieces you'll get that I've got, I'm really happy with them. And we'll definitely be using them on my Temir Jeep, at least the front wheels anyway. we'll see what happens with the back ones. As always, guys, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll catch you later.